Hi everyone, welcome to another Greenleaf Terrain Showcase. This time I have a docks display board that I've done up for client D from FutureGen. The backdrop of buildings is interchangeable. I will show that off later where the guy on the right side can be changed for the three set of buildings on the left side. All of the other pieces, the sets of crates and whatnot are all modular, so you can place them wherever you need to for whatever display you need to do. This guy is also modular. I had him placed up backwards like this for some pictures that I was taking earlier. And yeah, so the board is a quarter inch MDF 2 foot by 2 foot board that is rimmed with 8 inch MDF. The base of this is 1 inch foam and another layer of 1 inch foam, high density insulation foam, then some half inch for these retaining walls. These are little foam balls that have been glued on and painted silver. These, all the gears that are amongst the project are laser cut from Ironheart Artisans. The docks are made with balsa and dowel. I cast the crates out of resin, and all the buildings are made with a variety of balsa wood, plastic card. All the doors and windows are cast, the Greenleaf Terrain cast. The roofs are done with some cardstock. This part of the roof is done just with some sand. I think that's everything. Did I say foam core? Foam core for these buildings. Those are foam core. This is foam core as well, but I've ripped the paper off the facade and done a brick pattern. I think that's about it. The little staircase is some foam as well. So here you can see the lip that the buildings slide into. And this is a set of three buildings, and you can see that they sit down inside nice and snug. And I will be right back when I switch these buildings from each side. So I was going to switch the set of buildings with this set of buildings, but it come to a slight design flaw where the overhang of this building makes it for this building can't fit there. So this is kind of the only setup with these other pieces being able to move. But I think it's okay. It gives a good variety of height. When these two buildings were kind of in the middle, yeah, I could see that it was going to kind of, I don't know. I like the kind of slope to it. So that's what we got going on. I will jump the camera off the tripod and we'll check everything out a little bit closer. So starting with this front corner, front of the board, we have the water section. I didn't explain before, but it has all been airbrushed up. Sorry, my light is playing off the resin. But then it was poured with a resin, and then I used some Mod Podge to give it this frothy, swirly look of the water. Again, this dowel and balsa wood dock was airbrushed up with a variety of colors. As you can see, there's some greens and oranges in there. I'm going to try to do something different to give it an aged look. That persisted through all of these crates. Picked out the metalwork on them and such. These little ramps are glued in. So again, there is 5 modular pieces for the whole set. And we have this small little side docks. The rock face was made with Sculpt-A-Mold, and some of this grit was just done with some sand. This building again features Ironheart Artisan gears. The windows and doors are a Greenleaf Terrain mold that I cast up in resin. It's all been airbrushed up. plastic card for the corner metal parts, and then it's done with a black foam core. And you can see these gears are kind of like a decorative thing going all the way along. I've done grime streaking and weathering throughout just to give the whole piece an aged look. I'll move this building before we can look back here. So this guy, painted on the side, the backs are all black. And there's a whole bunch of signs warning about a plague and abandoning the area if the plague comes and whatnot. So then we got these set of three buildings. That one features a couple wanted posters, sorry. And the brick pattern persists on the left of the building. Stairs are all made with a little bit of foam core. But it gives quite a bit of room to place miniatures all over the upper part of the board, lower part of the board, and on the docks here. You're only losing this small section, and then this little about 2 or 3 inches in the front there, and a little bit obviously here, but then it gives the board a lot of realism. So that gives you a look at all the parts of this display board a little bit closer. I went over what everything was made of, and I will have a full set of pictures of this guy up on my Facebook. A link to that will be in the description. If you were interested in setting up a custom terrain commission or miniature painting commission, you can email me at info@greenleafterrain.com, and I'll get back to you with the quote as soon as I can. Other than that, thanks for watching, please subscribe, and happy wargaming!